Do you have a winch?
On the front. This is about the only one I can't avoid. But I thought I could make it through. But the back tire is right on the edge of the mud hole.
Can I get over there through here?
Yeah, yeah, it's all safe.
You should have turned it this way. I know there's a big log there.
Yeah.
I'd go up to that stump, pull you straight in. That's gonna pull you right over there.
Well, I'm already headed this way a little bit. mud hole right here. Nice and slow with the gas.
Welcome back to the cabin, everyone. The first thing we're gonna do is level out the outhouse. So let's go ahead and get started.
Yeah. You ready?
Yep. Oh, Jiminy Cricket, it went.
Okay, let's clean it in. Might be clear off now. Here. I'll pick it up when you put that.
Go.
You don't have to do that. You're busted. Wait, stop. Please.
I got it.
Bill. I'll push it up and you push over in the bottom. This is easy to push up here. There. A little bit more.
Yeah.
Come back toward me.
Should, huh? Looks like it should come back about a good 2 inches.
About an inch, because right there's the old line. Yeah. So let's push it back. Here, come over here. See if we can't just slide it.
Uh-oh, hold on. Now this is, that board might work if you got something solid here.
Well, we just kind of got to wiggle it back.
Right.
That's pretty close.
Okay, yeah. Close enough.
Now, what I would suggest is you just push it up there on top.
You have more twist on it.
Well, I think I was off to the side too. I wasn't in the center. You ready?
Yep. A little more. Okay, you're in.
Okay. Yeah, I was too far on this corner. That's why it slid. You ready?
Yep. It'll settle down.
Yeah. Pull it up.
Close the door.
Now the outhouse is in line with the power shed.
So, I think I want to run it from these up over this, then across.
All right. So measure it from the far side.
So, well, that's 6 feet. So make that 7 feet up to there.
Why? Well, wait, but you're going to come
over
this way? Through, like, every one of these little turns chews up like a foot. Yeah, you gotta measure like pieces.
No. Enough, Frank.
Yeah, well, that would be enough to get the both of those. Also, just gonna let it kind of run wild.
Yeah.
Okay.
We need to untangle it. be enough fruit up there.
I want
to see if that drill is any good.
Grab the other battery.
Need to put these two in a little better.
Yeah. So I'm thinking like right about here.
Mm-hmm.
So need a 1.5 by 2.25.
2.25. No, no. As you come up, go a little bit that way, then you'll reach it.
Cut a hole for this too.
Yeah, what does that do?
This is the on and off for that. So I figure right above it.
Okay. You can't make those holes any too big because those screws are right there.
Yeah.
That's got to be a tight cut.
Yeah. Or even if it's just a kind of loose hanging there, would be fine. Where was it?
Here comes your neighbor.
Yeah, but then you have to crimp that, aren't you?
Yeah. But that's what I... But as soon as I crimped it on, I'm like...
Yeah, that's good. It's on the outside of that.
As soon as I crimped it, I'm like, oh, I forgot the jumper.
So when it is dark out here, I have light out here.
What? So they're like 1 amp.
Okay.
LED. Yeah, see, they're 10. That makes sense. Yeah, so they're going to draw 1 amp, is my prediction. 10, 1 amp, maybe like...
Turn.
I need a nut. Do you have a nut for this?
No.
Twist them.
Twist them.
Do you have some black tape though? No.
I mean, I don't have nuts this small.
That's something the guy should never say. Hand me those pliers. Twist this little bit. Do you have black tape or anything?
Yes.
Okay, are you ready?
Yep.
Turn big test.
Now try it.
That's low.
And that's high.
There you go.
Our time's come to an end here at the cabin. We got several important things done, like we got firewood stacked over there and firewood stacked over there. Got the outhouse sitting upright totally and a few other little things, so we're gonna head back.